In this video, you will be learning about database connection in Talent Studio. This is achieved using the metadata feature in Talent, which is basically, it creates a data about data, which is nothing but it contains all the connection details, server name, database name, the user credentials, everything in metadata, which can be further used and reused across all your jobs in Talent. Alright, so once we create this metadata, we'll also look at how do we make use of it and how do we propagate any changes that are coming into the table. And once this database connection is done, we will also look at a way to create a metadata for a CSV file. And this is similar to the database, wherein we store the metadata details of a file, such as the file name, the delimiter, the header, and such details in a metadata. And we'll also start using that in a Talent job, and we will see how to load from a database to a CSV, from CSV to a database. Alright, let's get started. I'm on MySQL Workbench now, and as you can see, I have created a table called user_detail. So this table now contains a few columns that are related to user, and we'll be using this structure into our Talent metadata, and then we will start using this table from this metadata. Alright, let's go to Talent Studio. Alright, as soon as you log into Talent Studio, if you scroll down on your left window, you should be able to see a feature called metadata. Go ahead and expand that. Under that, you will be seeing database connections, and also you see the file delimited metadata as well. So let's go ahead and start creating the database connection. So we'll just give some name. Click next. So the first thing we choose is the DB type, which is in our case MySQL. And once we choose, we will have to provide the login details. For now, we have RBS dev user, and the password, and then type in the server name. In my case, it's hosted on my local computer, so I'm going to use that, and I'm going to use my database name as RBS dev. Let's go ahead and test the connection. Alright, the connection is successful now. Click OK and then hit finish. Alright, so now our metadata for a database connection is now created. Now let's navigate to our jobs. So this is a miscellaneous job. Let's go ahead and use it. So in this particular job, we will look at creating the metadata connection for a database and a file, and then we'll read data from a file and load it into a database, and read data from database into a file. So that we cover database section, file section, and also reading and loading part as well. So now on my local folder, I have a directory called input, and I'm using a user details file. And as you can see, my table was empty. So first thing, I will load this file into database. Under the metadata section, right click on the file delimited, click on the create file delimited, type in the name, click next. And since this is a Windows one, let's click and choose the Windows, browse for that particular file. And as you can see, we have used comma as our delimiter, and also we have a header in the file. So in order to set those two, in the file setting, you have an option called field separator. Go ahead and select comma. And we also have the header in the file. So click on heading row as column names, and when you click this, automatically this will add the header row as one, and click on refresh preview. All right, now we can see the data properly arranged, and all of our header details on the first row. All right, that's all. Click next and click on maybe you can give a better name for this, and then click finish. All right, so now that we have created a database related metadata, and also we have created the file metadata, so now our file has the data. So let's use this file and then load it into a table, and that way we can demonstrate the usage of metadata in this sample job. All right, let's go ahead and click on user detail, the file metadata, bring it to the job design area, and it gives us several options since it's a CSV file. You get a pop-up here for the components. So it gives us a few suggestions automatically since we are dealing with a CSV file. Let's go ahead and click on file input delimited. Click OK. So this by default, it will create a DB input file delimited component. And as you can see, the property type and schema type is a repository, which means all the details for the schema and the connection are derived from the metadata. So let's say if something changes on the file, all you can do is just do a right click and then retrieve schema. If you are changing if you're adding a new column or removing a new old column, then you can just do a retrieve schema and the change will come to the metadata, and this can be reused across all the jobs. If you have 10 jobs referencing this table or a file, and you want to propagate that new change to all the jobs, that's when the metadata comes in handy. It is applicable for the file and also the database connections. You can make the change at one place, and then as soon as you make that change, it'll ask you whether to propagate the change to all the jobs that are referencing. Alright, so now that we have brought in this input component, let's also bring in this database into a job design window. And as we said, we'll read the file data and then dump it into our database. So let's go ahead and click on DB output MySQL. Click on OK, and all we have to do is do a right click, row, and then more main. You can connect to the target table. And as you can see, when you double click on the target component, you can see the basic setting for this. Again, you see repository, so everything is coming from the metadata. If you change anything, you do the retrieve here, retrieve schema, and then your job will be automatically pointing to the new structure of the table. Alright, so all the connection details, everything is in the metadata, so we don't have to worry on that. Now we will have to look at some of the actions here. The first thing, it'll ask you to what table I should be loading it, and you have an action on table. So what it does is basically, if you don't have the table, you can create the table. There are a couple of options wherein you can create table if it does not exist. If it already exists, you can drop and recreate, or you can just clear the table or truncate the table. These are the action on the table. The action on data specifies whether you want to do blind insert or update, or insert or update, or just do a delete or replace. These sections we will talk in our upcoming videos. So for now, I'll go ahead and click on insert, and as you can see, the schema is already automatically copied from our source to target. No need to make any change here. Go ahead and click save. So when we run this job, all the data from the file will be loaded to the target table. And there are a few other options here. If you move to advanced settings, you can specify commit every value. This basically means if the file has more than 10,000, auto commit would be auto commit will happen for every 10,000 records. All right, so we have a few more options here. We will look at it when we get to the advanced topics. For now, we will just go ahead with this commit interval and then basic settings on this target component. All right, let's go ahead and run the job. So for that, we'll go to the run tab and click on run. All right, as you can see, the records are loaded from the file into the target table, and the target table will be specified in this section, so you're familiar with this. And then let's go back to our table and see if we have. So initially, before loading, there were no records. Let's go ahead and do a count on the table. Now we can see 1000 records, and let's see. So these are the table values. These are the values coming from the file. So now we have successfully loaded our file data into the target table. So this is about reading file and then loading data into target table. In the next task, we will read from this table. We'll read from this table and we'll create a new file on the target output folder. All right, so let's go ahead and right click and then do a deactivate on the current sub job, because when we run the job again, I don't want you to run the same task again. Right click on this connection and then you can click on retrieve schema. So what it does is it connects to the database and brings in all the tables. You can specify any filter. If you have hundreds of tables, you can specify a filter. For example, I just type in user, and in the next section you'll be able to see all the tables that are having that filter. Just go ahead and click on this and then click next, finish. So what it does is, under this metadata we have this table definition already captured. When we are building a job, you can directly use this table and drag it and use it. So for that, let's go ahead and bring in this as the DB input. Let's specify the table name, user underscore details, and I would say select star from user underscore details. So one good thing, as you can see, there is no columns defined here. There's one good thing, it automatically connects to the database and retrieves the schema with this little feature here. So just click on get schema. So now it is connecting to the database and retrieved all these column names. Click OK. Now we can see all the structure. All right, our input component is now ready. All right, so for the sake of creating this output a little different, we will bring in component called tmap. Will connect from the DB input to the tmap. Tmap is basically a component wherein you can apply some filters or do some expression, add a new column. You can do a whole lot of things here. We'll be covering those in our upcoming videos. So keep watching and subscribe to my channel so that you can see all the new updates coming in. Alright, so I have created a new output called inserts. I'm going to just do a drag and drop into my target, and I'll create a one expression here to print the time, the insert time. So for that, we have a ready-made function, talentDate, and under that, let's go ahead and choose getDate. Click OK and I think this is not selected. Click on get current date. Just do a double click. You can see that expression. Click OK. And since it's a data type as a date, let me go ahead and choose the date. Alright, so this is done. So I'll be adding a new column at the end, and we'll call this as let's say record insert date. All right, so we have created a custom column and then we are assigning the current date into this. Let's go ahead and click on apply and then click OK. All right, now let's go ahead and create a one output. So we'll be choosing that insert and just click here, and you can click on the design window and choose file output delimited. So now what we're doing, we are reading the data from the database, adding one extra column, and that we are propagating it to the target. So as you can see, all the columns are automatically copied over. And the output, I want it to be written into, so there's an output folder here. So I want the output to be written here with createDate.csv. Alright, so this is my output file. I want it to be separated by a new line character, and I will keep my delimiter as comma, and I'll include the header on that target file. Go ahead and save the job. Let's go to run tab and then hit run. Alright, as you can see, 1000 records are read from that table, and then a file is created on the target. Let's go ahead and verify if it is created. In the output folder, we have this file created, user detail underscore create date. Let's go ahead and try to edit. Alright, as you can see, a file is generated with the comma delimited and the header on the top. Alright, so that's all about creating the metadata for a database connection and also file connection. And in these two examples, in the first example, we use the file to load data into the table. And in the second example, we have seen data retrieval from a database table and then writing into a file. Alright, that's all for this video. We'll have more advanced videos coming up. I hope you like it, and happy learning. Thank you.